Today I'm doing a fruit stand for my wife, and I'm a little late on showing y'all, so I may not be finished today, but I'm gonna show y'all tomorrow. But basically, she want this in the kitchen to put fruit in. She saw it in the store. So pretty much I made these stands, and I'm gonna put this basket in. I'll put the basket in on it, and that will hold it up. So I'm gonna show y'all how to make it, and I'm gonna put a 45 degree angle on it. But like I said, I may show y'all tomorrow. But as far as the box go, I got wood pallets. So let me show y'all. Oh, and don't mind the beeping, that's my garage battery. So we got some pallets here, and pretty much I broke all the pallets apart. Not all of them, but I broke some pallets apart and sanded it down. I will sand it down. I will sand it down some more. I sanded some earlier at, I forget what grit, rough grit, like 60 grit. So when it comes to building this right here, this is your best friend. Other than that, what else? This countersink, make the screws disappear, countersink the screws. And all right, right now I'm going to put the screws to support the bottom, put the screws on the side. I might just put one or two. It ain't gonna be that much fruit, and the fruit ain't gonna be that heavy. So right now I'll put one. If something happens in the future, I'll just put two. Like I said, you want a countersink. It's good to have two screw guns, that way you have to keep taking your countersink off and then put your drill bit in and all that. If you need longer screws, put in a longer screw. Right now I'm putting in one. Seems secure. Let me try 2.5. I may not need to use 2.5, but that's old. Nah, that's overkill. I need to get so 1.5. I think I got some. I just don't feel like getting it right now. And I may not put wood putty, because my wife don't mind seeing the screws being exposed. She actually like the antique feel of it looking like it was handmade. So, you know, it's a personal preference if you want the screws shown or not. But right now I'm just countersinking to where the screw is flush, so that way. That way it looks some type of presentable. Sorry, let me get a little closer for y'all. Still new to this. That's gonna be standing up soon. I know. Why don't I just lay it down? Duh. All right. put one, two. Might have to go a little bit deeper on that one. And then also, if you want to see how deep your screws in, just put it flush to where you're going, and then you can see how far in it goes. So like I said, if you want more support, put a longer screw. Or put one screw on one side, one on the other. If it goes nowhere with me doing that, it's not going nowhere with fruit in it. Like, this will hold oranges, your apples. We're gonna test out a watermelon. Put a watermelon on it, you know. So, all right, everything feels flush. Like I said, some of these are flush, some are in. That's if you want a putty, you make it deep. If not, make it flush and stain over top of it, and then it'll look good. All right, so now we're gonna put it on one of the legs. So bear with me on that. We are going to freestyle. All right. Now the back part of this is gonna have a little lip hanging out because I don't want the full 12 inches hanging forward. And I'll show y'all what I'm talking about in a little bit. All right. So let's see, it's 12 inches long. So let's do let's give it 3 inches, maybe 2 inches in the back. I'll do 2 inches in the back. Seven and a quarter. 12 inches. All right, so I'm gonna do 2 inches in the back, 2 inches space in the back, and then the rest will be, 6 inches in the front. Right? This, I am gonna put 2 screws in. Cause I want this to be well supported. But I could just put 1 screw in just to have it, the leg. Whoopsie. All right. One. That's 2. Now, if you just want 1 and you want to play around with the angle, you put 1 screw in, not all the way, but that way you can still go up and down with this. All right, let's put this like that. All right, now what we're gonna do is get our level. We're gonna get our level real quick. Get a clamp, get your level. Let me show y'all. All right, so it's on this one part. Like I said, if you would've put at least one screw on, you could play with this and go up and down. I'm gonna show y'all. Matter of fact, hold on, give me 1 second. That way I can show y'all. But I can do that later. You know what? I can do that once I squeeze that together. Okay. Sorry if the camera is too close. Okay, so right now, this is how I got it. Now the first one, I could have came down a little lower, but you know what? I may be able to design another basket down here. That would be pretty cool. But right now, I gotta match up the amount of inches from the back I got on this one. See this back part? This back overhang right here. I need to match up this side to that side so it can be even. You don't want this side to be further back and then this side further in, then it's shifted. So what we're gonna do is get our measuring tape, measure the back part. I got 2 and we're gonna try to get accurate as possible. So we're gonna go 2 1/4. 2 1/4. So we're gonna try to make this back 2 1/4. And then we gotta get level. So we got almost. Come in a little bit. Come in. All right, 2 1/4. We're gonna tighten that real quick. We're gonna check the level. We want to check and make sure that one side is not up and one side not down. Right now, we're doing a shift. All right, level. These are old levels, but oh, we are almost level. Come up. Yeah, perfect. That is perfect. What I'm gonna do while it's, make sure we squeeze it tight. And put some screws in it. Done. Now what I did was, what I did was use my countersink and I screwed 2 holes on the inside. That way I have my support for my fruit or support for the basket. All right, 1 screw in. 2nd screw in. 2nd screw in. I'm gonna blow all that stuff out anyway. Okay, take that off. All right, and there we got a basket. We got our first basket. That's how you start your fruits, your little fruit basket. Pretty cool. Hold on a second. Okay, everybody, I'm ready to show y'all how to do the box real quick. I'm gonna do the 16-inch, length on it, and I'm gonna show y'all real quick. Okay. With this is rough. I'm not really trying to be perfect with it. My wife don't like, she, like I said, she like it, make it look like it's been handmade. She don't like it how it looks manufactured. So that's the way, you know, certain people like their things. Once you make your first cut, you can just cut the rest. I could get maybe like 2/16 out of here. Nope, can't get 2/16 out of here. But I could get at least one. How many 12s? Because I need 2 12s. 12, 24. I can get 2 12s out of here. I need 12s for the arms. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 16s. 5 16s, 2 12s. 5 16s, 2 12s. I say that for later because I might need 2 12s again. As a matter of fact, let me match it up with this. These are 16s, put them together. This got a crack on it, but you know what? I'm gonna try to bypass this crack and put some glue on it and seal it back together. So I'll take the part that's less crack on it. Let's see what happens. Let's see if we can make it happen. Your 3 16s, this is going to be for the bottom. Then you want to do 2 more 16s for the front and the back. Then do your 12 inches for your side. You're going to make sure it's 12 inches that we need. We'll do that once we figure out these two sides right here. So we're going to get 2 more 16s. 2 more 16s. I got a piece behind me too. Oh no, I said I was gonna use it for the 12. Sorry. Let's see. We can get 2 16s. Definitely get 2 16s out of this. Let's see this wood. 16. Damn. Just made 2 16s out of here. Match this up. Get 3 16s right there. Put one right here. And then this piece should be 16. Let's see. A little bit less. Let's see if we can move it now. Oh. But we can still make it happen. You know what? Let's make it happen. They don't have to be perfect because the sides are covered. All right, let's see what we got. Let's see what we got for the side. Let's make these 12s. 24. This is, like I said, I'm just showing y'all real quick, but this is easy, man. If you want to make yourself a little fruit stand, right now. I'm doing the side, which is 12 inches. Put a little line on it. Now, some of these are a little bit uneven because I don't have like a blocker right here to block it to make sure that it's the same width. So pretty much you can eyeball it. Try to get it close as you can. If one's longer than the other, like this, say if one's just like a little bit longer, put both together on the back, put the blade close to it, make sure the back is even. Scoot it back just a little bit. And that way both of them could be, that's how you get both at the same cut. Put it on the side. Let's see what we got. Yep. That's how you do it. That's how you make your box. Now I said, this, like I said, this is a little bit shorter. If I really wanted to, I could either leave it and try to work with it. But I'm just, since I got enough pieces out here, I'm just gonna make another one. And I can use that as another 12. No big deal. All right, got that. All right, so what we're gonna do with this one, what we're gonna do with this is, we're gonna cut another 16. What we got here, we'll save this, but this didn't make the cut. It didn't make the cut. All right. You know what? This is small. What I'm trying to do is not cut to where you're wasting pieces. I'm trying to use as many pieces as I can for the right piece. I got a lot of wood, but that's just how I operate. Cut this 16 real quick. I'll screw the sides on first just to have the box in. So I'll do that real quick for y'all. All right. Oh boy. Get old. All right. All right. I got everything in. Got those close. All right. Perfect. Like I told y'all in the other video, or like I told y'all earlier, just mash these up. Screw up top, screw on the bottom, screw on the bottom. Screw up top. If you want a countersink, put the screw in a little bit deeper. Two. I'll sand. I do a little light sanding on that, so that way nobody'll catch splinters when they go get their fruit. Let me move it back for y'all. Not sure if y'all can see, so hopefully y'all can see what I'm doing. Okay. That step 4 times. So that was. Right.
flip it around, do the other side. Simple as that. It's just that simple. That's it. Did your sides. Now you gotta do the bottom support. Oh, wrong. Wrong drill. All right, that's tight. That's tight. All right. Now, like I showed y'all a little while ago, we're gonna put a screw in each. Using one, you could put two to make it more secure. Like I said, if I need it more secure, I will make it more secure. I will take it apart. I'm the type that if I mess up something, I will take it apart. If I don't like how I did something, I will take it apart. Don't matter to me, okay? All right, same thing. I'm gonna put three screws in. One. If y'all heard that noise, my drill was rubbing on the floor, so yeah. Now, like I told y'all, I'm gonna say it again. You know, just so if you're looking at my video and you're doing exactly what I'm doing, you don't get mad at me. I put one screw in for this. For me, it's enough weight. If you know, it's not bending back, forth, or whatever. I'm putting regular oranges, apples, or stuff. But if you're using this and you put heavy weights in it, or whatever, tools, and it collapse and all that, I told you to put two screws in. There we go. It's all coming in together. That's how you make a quick basket. And then, oh, sorry y'all, I got old on y'all. All right, now I'm gonna move y'all here again. Now, like I said, the angle could be whatever angle you want it to be. You could use the square to put a 45 degree angle, or you can use, you could use it to put in 15 degrees or whatever angle you want. So
With us, we're eyeballing it and we're just winging it out.
So. Uh-oh. Let's start from the top. All right, this is gonna be tight. But that's what we need, tight fit. All right. See, so tight. So much of a tight fit, and that's perfect. Now we're gonna make sure we have the same amount of back space. The space in the back, like I showed y'all right here. You see this back space? I want the same amount. So we had 2¼, and what you do is use your measuring tape. And see if you got 2¼. But if not, if you want this further back, it's up to you. But the reason why I'm doing it is because it's gonna be beside of a counter. And I will show you the finished product and I will explain why I did everything I did. So, got that. Right. Okay. I will get the clamp in a little bit once I get my measurement. Ooh, that's 3 inches. You know what? I'll let it go. Just so it can be back. Well, you know what? No. Let's bring it up. Scooting it up. Let's try to get this 2¼. Just to make it even. Like I said, if I need to make an adjustment, 2¼. If I need to make an adjustment, I will take the whole thing apart. That's just the type of person I am. Some other people, it's too much work to take it apart. Like I said, I'm doing a custom tilt. The last one, I might just make it a flat basket on the top and tilt these. So, like I said, doing my own thing. Everybody else can do their own thing. I haven't seen nobody. The videos I saw was a little bit more different, like I said, but you know. Everybody does their own thing. Let's see. 2¼ is close enough. Let's screw this baby on. Oh, I'm sorry if y'all couldn't see. See, I'm starting to get used to the YouTube thing, and I'm usually just working by myself, not really worried about a camera. So I just want to show people what I do almost every day. I'm always doing something. I'm always occupied. That's why I named the channel Always Occupied. You'll see me do a lot of stuff on this channel. But, okay. So you see, I put the angle I want. They all not the same. It might be two different angles. This one looks a little bit straighter. But like I said, if you want a perfect angle, you can use a square or they got a tool that does angles. So, if you want a certain angle, you can do whatever you want. But this, I'm just eyeballing it, winging it out, and going with the flow. So right now, let's go ahead and start screwing this side up. Put our countersink holes in it. Battery's dying, and I do not have another battery charged. I don't think I will have to look. If not, I'll just use the drill that I'm using. All right. We'll go ahead and screw this side in. And then we'll set up, we'll level for the other side. Let me just put one in. I just put one screw in for now. Let's see. This has to come down. 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 Oh, that's perfect. It is. Well, y'all can't see it right now, but. Oh, give me one sec. Sorry, y'all. It's perfectly level across. That's all I'm looking for. I don't want it to look like crap. It could look handmade, but still don't want it to look like, you know, it's leaning more on one side than the other. All right, now let's see if I got my 2 1/4 inches. Okay. Let's see if I got 2 1/4 inches. I'm coming. All right, y'all. My day is almost up because I got to attend to my kids. Two and a quarter inches and level. Countersink. Sorry, I have to rush on y'all. Come on. All right. One more battery. Come on, please. It's okay. As long as I can get one screw in, we good. I'll finish showing y'all tomorrow what I'm gonna do. All right, that's in. Woo. All right. We almost there. Okay, now like I said, I don't know, for the top, I might have it flat. You know what I'm saying? I might have a flat box on the top and the rest leaning. Something different. I never seen it in the store. I seen something similar to this in the store where they all three land in the angle. So we'll see. Stay tuned. I will finish this maybe tomorrow because I got to go to work. So... yeah.